Hey guys, what's up? Yes, yeah, so I'm in my, well, it's a second bedroom, but I've turned it into my candle palace. I was gonna do a car chat, but I'm just now feeling better. Since Sunday, I've been like MIA a little bit on social media because it was that time of the month, and mine, guys, is terrible. It takes me out for days. So that's kind of where I've been. Sorry, I'm all congested. But yeah, I feel 100% better now. So I just wanted to hop on, do a little quick like chit chat video while I'm here at the house. I'm gonna clean up. Today is cleanup day. After I feel better, I'm like on this clean kick. So that's what I'm doing today. So I'm gonna start in here and kind of just like get things organized because I just feel like things are all over the place, and that's what I'm gonna do. And I'm probably gonna melt some wax melts that I brought from a company, a small business, a girl that I follow on my Instagram, so I can relax. So I kind of just wanted to talk to you guys about a topic that I was having a conversation with my therapist last week. Every Friday I have my therapy session, and the topic that we talked about was broken relationships are okay. So it kind of doesn't make sense, but it will, but it might to some. But basically what I've been going through since moving to Florida from New York and just being away from like all my friends and family that I have back home is certain relationships have shifted, and I can feel it, but that's just me being an empath already. But you're just starting to see the change. And in the beginning, it was difficult for me because I was always the one that tried to keep everybody together. I was always the one that was like doing like all the family events and trying to, you know, keep that alive, because as people know, yesterday was also my mom's anniversary of her passing, June 9th, 2012, she passed away. So yesterday was just like kind of a hard day for me as well. But, you know, just coming to the sense that some relationships that you've had all your life with friends and family may be broken for whatever reasons, it takes a little toll on me because I'm very family oriented, and when I have friends, I love all my friends just like I do on my family. But when things start to change and people change, you have to be able to cope with that. So I'm just coming to terms, you know, with some relationships that you know, sometimes my honesty, because that's part of my personality, affects my relationships as well. But like the therapist said, sometimes it can be a downfall, sometimes it doesn't. You know, you shouldn't completely change who you are as a person because someone doesn't like to hear the truth or be honest, or you're being honest with them. So I've had some conversations with friends and family where I was honest about certain things, and in my mind, how the actions that are being towards me, not speaking to me now or just acting different with me, just goes to show that they just don't want to hear the truth, or I said something that they know what it is, but they just don't want to indulge in it and deal with it. So I'm just coming to the term that I just always have to remain the person that I am and never downplay who I am as a person because other people don't like it. And yeah, I know I'm 35. That's something that we all should know, right, at this age. But, you know, there's just certain relationships that you do just want to keep, but sometimes you can't fight to keep it going, and it just is what it is, you know? So that was kind of the topic, because like I said, I don't mind sharing the conversation. Some conversations I won't. Like tomorrow, we will be speaking about like things with my mom, so I probably will not be sharing that. That's going to be very private. But yeah, I think I'm just coming to terms that, you know, some relationships, family and friends, are just going to be finito, done. And that's fine, right? People just grow, and sometimes you just grow apart. And yeah, I will always love these certain people, but you know, I just can't keep with the back and forth, and it just not working. You know, people really will act as if they like you, but they really don't. And you know, it's just crazy. I think just I was telling my therapist, like, just it's crazy that being honest with someone is not the right thing to do, it seems as if. So I don't know, but you guys let me know what you think. Have you ever gone through something where, you know, it's a family or friend and you've tried to keep trying to make it work and it's just the same thing over and over? You know, you'll talk to somebody about it and you kind of hear yourself saying the same thing over and over about this person. So that's your answer, right? That it's just not changing. So you just have to move on, don't you? So let me know what you guys think about this. I just kind of wanted to throw the topic out there because, you know, I started therapy for my mental health, and I always push that mental health movement. Y'all know how I am. And it's just opening up a lot of doors, good and bad. You know, some of the conversations really take you there. And it's only been my second, well, this will, yeah, Friday, tomorrow will be my third session. And it's crazy how much has already come out. So, you know, if you, like I said, if you haven't tried therapy and you think you might want to try it, take that step and see what's going on. But yeah, that was the topic of last week. But yes, I feel more better. My skin looks good. I have my welly on, if you guys can see. These are the things I use. I get them from Target. They're the little pads that you put on little acne. I swear by these. I tell everybody about them. But yeah, so let me know what you guys think about that conversation. Let's talk in the comments and keep that mental health movement going. Oh, and I'll show you what else I got from Target, just to leave on a light note. So Target always got something. Well, I got two packs of the wellies. This is what they look like, guys, if you ever do want to try them for your pimples during any time of the, you know, because for me as a woman, I only break out when I'm on my mother nature thing. But they come in so handy, and it takes it away so fast. But I got two packs of those, and then I got this nice shirt, nice little tank top. It was $5 from Target. Yep, very comfy. I love the color. It's a nice brown. And then I found these shorts that had the same color in them, high-waisted, and these were $15. So yeah, that's what they look like in the back. So I don't know, I'll probably wear them this weekend, whatever we're gonna do. I know we need to go on the jet ski because we haven't gone but in a while. But yeah, so I just wanted to show my face and wish you guys a good day. And maybe I'll film tomorrow. I don't know what I'm gonna film. Very sporadic. Oh, I'm going to drop a video, guys, in my description box for all the YouTubers. Of course, you guys, a lot of people have channels that watch me and a lot of people may not. But I saw this video yesterday, and she was speaking truth on the YouTube world. I'm not a big YouTuber, of course. I only have 160 followers. But for those who want to really get into this and really do it, just watch the video and just see what she speaks on. And yeah, it was good. And we need to take it there. I was like, okay, I'm with you. So I'm going to drop that in the description box so you guys can check it out. And like I said, I hope you guys have a good week. No, a good day. And I will see you in the next video, okay? Bye-bye.